the reaction, the fallout to Ron DeSantis and his goofiness down there, okay, in the state of Florida, this sweet Rosa Parks and that story that every school child should know and comes to realize that there was a different time in America that perhaps still permeates today, it will lose context because now a publisher has deleted key details in Rosa Parks' story just for the state of Florida. And when we say deleted key details, like the whole thing, okay? They're making it seem like one day Rosa Parks just decided, I don't feel like getting up today, I'm tired, I'm just being a little lazy. So I'm gonna just stay seated. No other context, okay? No other context. New York Times has reviewed some proposed changes that publisher studies weekly made to its course materials and found that it erased references to racism in its books telling the story of Rosa Parks. According to the Times, the publisher made the changes in an attempt to cater to Florida, which has adopted stricter guidelines on so-called woke textbooks under the administration of Governor Ron DeSantis. That's an old picture, by the way, okay? He does not look like that. And I'm not gonna go further, but you understand what I'm saying. That's an old picture. So I don't know if he put that out or it's been retouched. It should be updated. Florida Department of Education tells the Times that it is entirely permissible to talk about racial discrimination when discussing the civil rights movement and that it did not mandate the proposed revisions to Studies Weekly's text. The changes in detail. Under the publisher's current version of the Rosa Parks lesson, which is intended for first graders, the book states that Parks deliberately defied a law that said African Americans had to give up their seats on the bus if a white person wanted to sit down. However, in the most recent proposed revision to the book, the text only states that Parks was told to move to a different seat without any explanation as to why. Now, let's pause there, Rayyvana. Have you ever gone to a function where it says certain seats are reserved, and maybe the sticker fell off the seat and you plop down there. They say, excuse me, Rayyvana, this is reserved for so and so. Would you mind sitting over there? That's how this looks. Where's the context here, okay? From this brave little lady warrior all those years ago, which if we're down in Florida, it seems like it's yesterday, could have happened this afternoon.
It's horrifying because the story of Rosa Parks has already been so whitewashed in the American education system. You know, schools teach that she was fresh. Typically they'll teach about Jim Crow laws and how she had to give up her seat for a white person, but they'll just say she was tired after a long day and didn't want to do it. And she was tired of having to move. When in reality, this was a planned protest. This was a planned protest. She was an activist before and after this. Throughout her life, she was an activist. That she intended to not give up her seat. Her and several others went on that bus in an act of defiance against the busing systems there. That's not taught already. So now to introduce a version of events where racism doesn't even come into play. I mean, how could you teach the civil rights movement if you're not even able to teach about racism? And you know, we've touched on this before, and I really don't want to say I told you so in this case, but I've been saying this, Dr. Richey's been saying this, you've been saying this, everyone at TYT has been saying this. Even if the laws don't say explicitly that you can't teach these types of things, they will have a chilling effect. Publishers, teachers, administrators, anyone within the school system or who participates in it is going to be apprehensive to teach things like this for fear of violating the law. And that is exactly what happened here. So Florida can say, well, nothing in the law explicitly says you can't do this, but that publisher has attorneys that looked carefully at the letter of the law and decided we cannot include lines about racism in our retelling of the story because it will be in violation of the law. And that's exactly what the law was created to do, to scare them out of teaching about racism.
And the publisher, Studies Weekly, has accountants too. Because they could have just said, we're not changing our books. They could have, I don't know, I want to feel like Rosa Parks did and have a little bit of courage. I don't know, muster up a little, lose a few dollars, okay? I get it, okay? I don't think all of these people who are afraid and have worked for their life's work, their careers should have to give it all up because the governor is a blowhard. Okay, I don't think they should have to. But again, this is a Rosa Parks moment. You're either gonna muster the courage, lose some coins, maybe get hit with a felony. Okay, I know they say the law doesn't expressly say, you're right, Rayyvana. Okay, you're always right, by the way. We love you. It's sick. How about you don't change the book instead of being like a feather? What's next? You're just gonna keep doing these things? Stop. Another example, publications trying to appease Florida officials. Axios dismissed a journalist, Ben Montgomery, after he responded to a press release from the office of Florida Governor Ron DeSantis by calling it, quote, propaganda. Where's the lie? The press release was regarding a Department of Education event hosted by DeSantis. According to the release, the event is titled Exposing the Diversity, Equity and Inclusion Scam in Higher Education. Propaganda. DeSantis has made targeting woke in schools the center of his platform, as well as restricting materials deemed obscene in public schools. Something his critics claim is a way to target LGBTQ or Black history related materials. This is propaganda, not a press release. That's all it took, and then you, really? Who's running things? DeSantis, okay? After Alex Lan Franconi, communications director for the Florida Department of Education, shared screenshots online of the reply, DeSantis press secretary Brian Griffin also commented, calling Montgomery's response modern journalism. Vanity Fair's Charlotte Klein first reported on Tuesday that Montgomery had been fired over the email. Axios confirmed to Media Light that Montgomery is no longer with the company, but did not specify the reason. At least own it. This reporter is no longer with Axios. Out of respect for our employee, respect. Do I have to read the whole thing? Or can you all just read it silently off the screen? Are you respect for your employee? This brother got fired for just saying what we all see. Like that commercial, Rayyvana. We all see it.
First of all, it's so offensive to say that it's out of respect for your employees. I mean, you fired the man for speaking the truth. I also say there's this really pernicious idea, I think, that a lot of people hold, that journalism is walking the line, right? That you report things from both sides, and if you tell it from both sides, then in the middle is the truth. That's not the case. The truth is the truth. You don't take a little bit of what fascist propaganda says and then a little bit of what, you know, righteous activists are saying and then split the difference, and that's the truth. The truth is independent of that. So what he did was speak the truth. It is propaganda. He emailed something that was objectively true and got fired from his job for it. And Axios is a right-leaning, you know, news conglomerate. So I'm not like surprised necessarily that they would take DeSantis's team's side in this, but it is really disheartening because the right wing wants to have you believe that they're fighting the good fight for ethics in journalism, when in reality they're just trying to silence people who disagree with them, people who want to report the truth. They want them silenced, who have the nerve to call out their BS. I mean, it really is, it's propaganda. That's all it is.
Yeah. And you would think somebody who is married to a former journalist, Jill DeSantis, a former journalist and television host. Well, never mind. I'm not surprised. You know how many people I sat next to, and I said, you don't know anything about what's going on in the story, and your hair is, it's too much hairspray. Okay. I once got in an argument with a girl who kept spraying and spraying. You know, she's spraying chemicals all over the place, and not all of us want that. I like flyaways, and I'm gonna keep mine. Okay.